Hi, my name is Frida Mills. I'm speaking to you from our corporate office in Brooksville, Florida at Skin for Life. Today's training video is on the Pure O2 Oxygen Infusion Machine. This little machine has made a splash in the aesthetic industry. So let's talk about the installation of your investment, your Pure O2 Oxygen Infusion Portable Machine. With the Oxygen Infusion Portable Machine, you will receive three products. You will receive a brightening product, which is our phase one brightening, and then you will receive an ACE complex, which is another phase one. The oxygen infusion brightening phase one is for variation of pigmentations concerns. So if you're working with melasma, chloasma, solar lentigines, any type of variation of pigmentation that is induced by sun exposure. And with the oxygen infusion ACE, this is your triple antioxidant. So this really works well with nourishing the skin, but also very good for mature skin, aging skin, skin that needs a little bit more of a TLC for nutritional purposes, and really boosts the amount of indirect responses on the cellular level. The last product is our oxygen infusion activator phase two. Now this is the complete performance of your treatment. The oxygen activator phase two, it actually indirectly connects and communicates with the enzymes within the stratum corneum. So this is a chemistry response. The phase one is all about the corrective responses, but the phase two completes the response and the treatment by really activating and communicating with the enzymes within the stratum corneum. The enzymes within your stratum corneum become excited and they become catalysts. So they break down this formulation into an O2 experience for your skin. This has a therapeutic action. It not only has a surface action for immediate skin change, but it has a therapeutic action. So we treat this product as a performance-driven product. All of the LSS phase one, whether it's ACE, brightening, sensitive, antibacterial, they all have the LSS delivery system. So this is our trademark secret for really creating a better communication on an immunology level for the skin. So when you purchase a Pure O2 Oxygen Infusion Portable Machine, you'll receive the brightening, the ACE, and the activator. The sensitive and the antibacterial are separate and you may purchase them additionally. So let's go ahead and start with the installation. It's very simple. You have the portable unit along with having an airbrush, and you have the LED ports if you want to purchase additionally. Now we sell variations of this machine. So you can purchase a standard unit without the LED or the standard unit with LED. We also have another variation which you may purchase with LED, oxygen, and our skin scrubber. So our skin scrubber is another additional as far as really making this a complete unit, a complete treatment for your clients. So it has all the versatility and all the advantages of really delivering a performance-driven treatment. All right, so let's start with the airbrush. Now, this little portable machine has a O2 compressor and it does have 20.9% oxygen flow. Now, most of you or some of you might have a concern with that. Understand, when you blow oxygen on the skin, it has no penetration value. It's just a spray. So what we have to do is we had to formulate for chemistry purposes so that the enzymes within the stratum corneum can activate and take that formulation and break it down into an O2 experience. So it is a chemistry-driven, performance-driven, immunology-driven skincare treatment. So the performance of using our skincare, our oxygen skincare, just elevates the more of the interaction with the skin, and it elevates the immunology, the lymphocytes, it elevates the oxygen experience. So everything is about cellular responses and how to increase the metabolic rate. So with this unit, the air that you breathe is the same amount of air that comes out of this machine. It is the chemistry of the phase one and phase two that really accelerates why the skin has that O2 oxygen, pure oxygen experience. So it's all about therapeutic action, treating variations of pigment, variations of lines, wrinkles, conditions that result in intrinsic aging or extrinsic aging. It also is very good for grade one acne conditions or all the way to grade four. So you have more of a creative versatility of really delivering a very good result-oriented treatment. And not only the antibacterial, but we also have the formulation for sensitive skin. So sensitive skin being rosacea, psoriasis, anyone that has either temporary sensitivities or chronic sensitivities. It is a perfect solution for trying to desensitize the skin to a point that you can really elevate their skin function and elevate their skin experience so that it will help to maintain a healthy capillary, but also a healthy functionality of the skin. So let's talk about the airbrush. The airbrush is going to be where you pour the O2 activator, the phase two activator. So when you received your airbrush, it will come without the hose attached, and it will come in a nice secure packaging in your shipment. So with the end of the hose, you'll see that you'll have a silver attachment. It threads. So what you want to do is at the bottom of the airbrush, you're going to thread it until it's tight. Okay, until it's tight, and make sure that it is tight. Now, with your airbrush, you'll see that you have a lever. In order for the O2 activator to emit or to come through the front of the nozzle, you have to push down on the lever and pull back. Now, you can adjust the amount of flow by undoing the back end of the knob, and or to tighten it, we'll lock it where it doesn't give you any flow, or you can open it up that gives you maximum flow. But the important thing is, if you just push back the lever, it will only give you air. In order to open up the component, the stainless steel component within the housing of this airbrush, you have to push down and then pull back in order to have the flow of the O2 activator come from the airbrush gun. Okay, so this is your adjustment valve. This is what is going to adjust the flow of the activator coming through the airbrush, or to tighten it up where you get minimal flow. So why do we do this? Because with an airbrush, you can work on very specific targeted areas, whether you're working on acne lesions or if you're working on melasma, chloasma, different variations of pigmentation. So it's beautiful that you can use this tip for more target areas. So this gives you the ability of adjusting as maximum or minimal. But remember, you have to push down on the lever and pull back in order to obtain that flow of the O2 activator. So after you thread your silver attachment to the airbrush, now you want to insert the end of the black hose. So again, as we said before, you have a fitting that has little teeth inside that secure the hose. So what we're going to do is we're going to place one hand on the portable machine and insert the hose into the ring fitting, the black ring fitting. And you can give it a little tug to make sure that it's secure. So after you do this, you can, you know, start with your airbrush. And just to test it out, you can turn on the portable unit, and basically you will see that air does flow through. But again, in order to create the O2 activator and in order to for it to come through the airbrush, you must push down and pull back to get the full volume of that particular product. And the activator phase two is in the 6 ounce bottle. And basically what you need to do is use about maybe half a teaspoon to actually perform, or maybe even a teaspoon to perform a full three passes on the skin. So, you know, you will be, you know, quantity is going to be subjective. So you will be able to determine if you want to work just on the face only, face and neck, décolleté, arms, backs, incorporate the oxygen infusion treatment with a pedicure or a manicure. So it's totally up to you on how advanced you want to do, and therefore the quantity is going to be subjective. You're going to be working on different areas of the body with the oxygen infusion system. Okay, so now that we've worked and we know where to insert the airbrush into the portable oxygen machine, now you need to see where the power source is. The power source is in the back of the machine. At the very bottom, you'll see that it has a little insert that you would apply the power source, the power plug, into the machine securely. Okay? So this is where your power source is. You will also see our label with a serial number on the machine. When you want to call in and you want to replace products or whatever the case is, or if you have a concern with the machine, we'll always ask for your serial number. So please be aware that your serial number is at the bottom above the power source. Now, another feature, as I said earlier about variations of the Pure O2 oxygen infusion portable machine, is that you may add on LED. So the LED ports are right here, and you also have an LED on and off switch right here. So this is where you would insert the power supply for the LED handpieces. So your LED light and your power cord is right here. Now you want to make sure that all five pins are facing downward. So you can see that you want to match up the insert of the LED light. So what we're going to do is put them in and secure it and make sure that it is connected and secured. And then when you use the on and off switch, you'll see that this light is red. The red LED light is your primary light for any skin type, color, or condition. It is there to excite the cellular responses. And within this LED light, you'll see that you have five individual bulbs. Those are infrared. Infrared is a beautiful thing because, again, it communicates and it interacts with those cellular responses. So it's all about cell growth. And with that being said, that means you're going to stimulate cellular mitosis. So it is great for proliferation, for really exciting those cellular responses so that it can work on pigmented skin, tarnished pigment cells, as well as really communicating with other fibroblast cells in your skin. So with the red LED light, it is always going to be your first light that you will apply on the skin. And with this, the red LED light, minimal, it needs to be on the skin for 10 minutes. It can be maximum up to 20 minutes, but at least 10 minutes on the skin. And when you perform with this light, it is on a clean skin. We, Skin for Life, does not recommend using any kind of serums, moisturizers, conductivity gels, or anything like that, mask underneath the skin. Light reflects. And if you put an extra molecule in between the skin and the light, you're going to have a longer duration of how effective the light is going to respond to the skin on a cellular level. That is our philosophy. So with this being said, on a clean skin, you want to apply it directly on the skin. There's no space on the skin, directly on the skin, and then overlap it 50% as you go around, and just remember that you also want to have a timer so that you or your minimum time is 10 minutes. Your maximum time can be up to 20 minutes. It really depends on how you schedule your clients. And we also give you an additional light, which is the blue light. These are large hand pieces, so they will cover a large area of the face, the hands, the back, wherever you choose to use it on the area for treatment. So with that being said, the blue light is mainly used for oily and acne skin. You can also see it has five invisible lights, so it also comes with the infrared for cellular responses. So the blue light is going to be your go-to light for more of a combination oily and very acneic skin types. So just be aware of that. But even when you're working with the blue light, your first light that you will be working with is your red LED. Your red LED will be on the skin for a minimum of 10 minutes, and then you can transition to the blue light for an extra 5-10 minutes to complete the treatment, okay? So it really depends on the condition of the skin, but most estheticians, I just want everyone to understand that the blue light is a secondary, the red light is primary. So red light is first, and blue light is on top when you're working with a combination oily or acneic skin. Now let's talk about the other variation. We have three variations, like I mentioned. We have the standard unit, and then we have the standard with the LED. And now you can either purchase the standard with the skin scrubber, or you can purchase all three modalities, the portable oxygen with LED and skin scrubber. So this is our new device that we've added to the portable Pure O2 Oxygen Infusion portable system. So it's great because we've actually added a USB to the back of the port. So you have your own charge system. So let's show you that first. I'm going to show you that first, okay? There we go. So you can see the USB is right here. And because the power source is in, you're able to view it. And what's really cool, and what I really enjoy when I am working on my clients on a mobile capacity, because I go to my clients, but when I'm working on my clients, I can actually charge my phone and the skin scrubber at the same time if I chose to, okay? So it's great because anyone that works from their phone, whether they have different types of payment systems like Square or PayPal, whatever the case is as far as apps go, you can make sure that your phone stays charged. So just a little tidbit of information on that as far as like really working with this machine in its entirety. So with the skin scrubber, you can charge right back here. And go ahead and apply that, insert that into the charging. And you'll actually see the little light come on and it will start to blink saying that it's charged. Now with this particular unit, it will always use like a half light system. It doesn't all automatically go to a full charge where the light goes across the image. It just doesn't do that. The fully charge is about, I would say about 2 hours. For your scrubber to have a full charge. And you can use that duration, you know, throughout the day. Like I could finish a whole list of clients for that one day just on one charge. But again, it's subjective. So just make sure that you do charge it when it's not in use. And that way you'll have a charged skin scrubber before you start your treatment. Okay, so this is kind of like a nice little feature. So the what comes with the skin scrubber is the USB cord. So the USB cord can actually go into a regular outlet as far as like your phone plug, where you can just insert the USB and charge it anywhere in your room. So that's really nice as well. So with this, you have the USB for charging for the skin scrubber. But when you use the skin scrubber, you want to remove the USB and just use it as of itself, okay? So it is cordless when you're working with it. So with the skin scrubber, what's great about, and those that do work with the skin scrubber, they know this, that you can use it on any type of skin, you know, any skin type, condition, or color. It's great. So when you're actually using it, you get 25,000 pulses per second. So it gives a nice proliferation, it gives a nice exfoliation to the skin on a sonic level. So you have the side down for the exfoliation purpose, and then you can flip it over for penetration purposes if you want to do want to use it after your serums and so forth for, again, a deeper penetration of a nutritional value to the skin. So it gives you those two options. This side is down for exfoliation, flip it up. This side is up for product penetration. So it's a great little device. I mean, it's awesome. We enjoy working with it, and it makes it, again, a very complete system. You have the oxygen, you have LED, and you have the skin scrubber. So even if you're a mobile esthetician or you're just working in a small room and you want to save a lot of space, you do not yet have a microdermabrasion machine, and you see the value of having a skin scrubber, it gives you a complete versatile treatment. And it's something that you can break up as a specialty menu or keep them as treatment programs for skin success. It's totally up to you and how you want to incorporate it in your menu of services. Now, within the manual, you will receive within your manual the skin scrubber along with our enzyme exfoliant papaya complex. This automatically comes with this system. So this enzyme exfoliant papaya complex, remember, it also has the LSS delivery system, so very good for the immunity of the skin. It has a pH of a 5.5, so it's great on all skin types, colors, and conditions. You can use it on anyone. It has the raw papaya, so it has that activation automatically. You can use it with the skin scrubber. It does have activation when you add water to it. It will have a nice warm sensation. But again, it has a pH of a 5.5, so any skin is going to have a very good immediate result, but without irritation or additional trauma, okay? So with this, it comes with the skin scrubber and this portable unit. So we try to think about how estheticians are working, how skin therapists are working, beauty therapists. It is important that you have some type of versatility to your menu and be able to break it up and join things together and really do great programs, skin programs for your clients. So this gives you an opportunity to really diversify your menu and incorporate some serious performance-driven treatments, result-oriented treatments. And that's why we try to make it in the experience of the esthetician. The esthetician, we're thinking about you all the time and trying to make sure that you have the tools you need in order to create really successful skin treatments. So let's talk about diversifying your portfolio, diversifying your menu. The papaya automatically comes with the skin scrubber with the portable unit. Awesome. But then you want to add something different. So don't forget to use our skin scrub with the marine extracts. This is a great scrub. The ingredients come from France, and we are really proud of this product because it has the diatomaceous earth. It also has lactic acid, but most importantly, it has Lemuria digitata, a brown algae that is tremendously beneficial for lymphatic drainage and for overall skin circulation. So do not forget about this particular product. It is an accent to any spa menu, to any spa treatment, and it's something that you can use with your skin scrubber, okay? You have two different types of treatments exfoliations, where you have the enzyme exfoliant with the papaya complex, and you also have the skin scrub with the marine algaes. This is a pH of a 6, so they're very comparable to one another. This really, because of the diatomaceous earth, really brightens the skin, and with the lactic acid that also is formulated with this product, you get that nice, smooth, silky skin. So you have different variations of exfoliations that you can provide your clients with, having a different experience every time. Okay, so don't forget about the skin scrub with the marine extracts. It is awesome, and the tube is huge, as you can see. So you can, there's a lot for your money here. So let's clean our airbrush together. We're going to take our airbrush, and we're going to lift the lid off the body of the airbrush, okay, of the cup. So it just lifts off. You do not have to unthread or anything like that, okay? It lifts off, and you just take it off by flipping it off. So we're going to put that aside. And again, we use about maybe a fourth of a teaspoon of, or 1/8 of a teaspoon of the O2 cleaner. So we're just going to pour this in until it fills the little hole that's inside, okay? And has a nice good, I would say probably 1/4 of the cup needs to be filled with the O2 cleaner. So we're going to put back on the cap. So once you fill, then you put back on the cap and secure it, press down. And then what I usually do is I take a piece of gauze. You can take a piece of paper towel, a towel, whatever you want to use, something dry though. And then I'm going to turn on my O2. Now this is what's important. The nozzle of the airbrush needs to go against whatever material you're using to spray the O2 cleaner with. So the reason why is because this needle needs to have concentration of this cleaner in order for it to dislodge anything around that very vulnerable and very fragile needle. So we're going to, I'm gonna overlap my gauze, and I'm going to push down and pull back and start the tip by pressing the tip. Not hard, you just wanna connect the tip to the gauze or paper towel or towel, or whatever you're using, and just go in circular movements until it's all completed. So you're literally just going back and forth, making sure that the formula has dislodged anything within the housing and with that little needle. So that's it. So you just want to make sure that the front of the airbrush goes against the gauze or the towel or the paper towel that you're using, so that it will build up the solution around the little fragile needle, okay? And it will dislodge anything that is solidified around it. So when you look at your airbrush, this should all look stainless. It should look white and clean and stainless. So everything around this airbrush, the tip of the airbrush, is clean. So that's what's really important. So that's your first step, all right? Again, this should only take you about 30 seconds, so don't think it's gonna take you forever. You're just trying to clean the housing and the little needle in the front of the airbrush. So now we're going to just pop off the lid, put that aside, and then we're going to just take water, just plain tap water, it's nothing fancy. And we're going to, again, you just want enough that's about fourth of the weight of the cup, using about a fourth of the cup, and put back on the lid. And then we're going to take our gauze again and put the tip to the gauze, just like we did when we were cleaning it with the O2 cleaner. Just go back and forth and make sure everything is good. You're looking at the tip and it sparkles. That's a clean airbrush, all right? We don't want calls and we don't want airbrushes when we're looking at it. Then you have all this white or all this corrosion around the tip. Clearly that means that you have not cleaned it properly. So you're responsible of definitely make sure that you maintain this airbrush after every treatment. And you have to remember that when you do this, that's gonna preserve the life of your airbrush. This accessory is only 90 days because we have had customers call and it's due to poor maintenance that we've replaced their airbrush. So we don't want you in that predicament. And we do offer and we recommend that you buy an additional airbrush because it is very important to us that you're not without this treatment, because this treatment gives immediate results. It is great with other modalities, microdermabrasion, LED. It's great before microneedling or nanochanneling. It's great after dermaplaning. This is a tremendous asset to your treatment room. And if you're without this airbrush and it's because of poor maintenance, then you've got to understand that this is part of your investment with this machine and you need to maintain it after every client. It's part of your sanitation to your room. Make it a part of the sanitation so that if you're a spa director or a solo esthetician working out of their own room, it is your responsibility to make sure that you maintain that airbrush. And we do have videos on our website as well as on our YouTube channel that you can view and that you can see some of the troubleshooting that you can do. So make that a part of your reference is to go to our website, skinforlife.com, and look at the different videos that we have, and also make a reference to our YouTube channel if that works better for you. So cleaning this airbrush is your responsibility. We give you the tools, and we want you to be able to replace this as needed. Do not forget, just using water does not do it. It has to, the saponins within this formula has to work with the, it works with the stainless steel to make sure that everything is dislodged and cleaned properly. And it is important, it's part of your maintenance. And this is what we go over when we train you online. So your package will have the 15 treatments of the O2 cleaner, but it is highly recommended that you purchase an additional O2 cleaner that is 16 fluid ounces, so that you have that, you are ready to go, and you're never without cleaning your airbrush after every treatment. So when you purchase the portable oxygen with the skin scrubber, you'll have everything you need within that manual to keep you informed and give you detailed information, so that when you're looking at the face, you're able to do exactly the face directions that you need to perform with the skin scrubber. So all the information is within your manual. We also have the manuals online on our website. So go to skinforlife.com and check out the manuals. Now you'll be able to see the information once you log in. So if you do not have professional access, get it. Go online and register with us so that you'll have professional access and you can see behind the scenes materials for that we give to our licensed skincare professionals. So it's something that you can take advantage of and be able to see everything, images that you might want to have on your own website. You know, let us know, communicate with us, stay in touch with us so that we're able to help you build your business with Skin for Life. So thank you for your time. Thank you for letting me share this training video with you. I think it's very detailed, so you should be able to look at this training video and open up your box and be able to put the black hose in the proper place, the LEDs, the skin scrubber, and within that manual, you should see protocols that will help you go step by step when using this machine as well. So be creative. Remember, this is an immunology line. This is something that the LSS delivery system is only in Skin for Life skincare products. So take advantage of what's on our website, the videos, the materials. Once you log in, you'll be able to see everything. And that's what's beautiful about Skin for Life. We are here for licensed professionals. And if you need to talk to us, call us. You'll never get an automation. You will get a person answering the phone, so you can go directly to your question and we will help you find the answer and give you the answer. So again, review your manual. Look for the contraindications. Remember, this is a therapeutic action. So it's not just surface action. It has a therapeutic action approach. And you need to review your contraindications and your precautions. So this is what the manual is for. Review the directions as far as with the skin scrubber, all right? It has face directions so that you will know exactly how to perform with that skin scrubber. We do have videos online so that you can review. We have the complete video of the portable infusion oxygen machine and with the skin scrubber with LED light. It is on our YouTube channel. So take a look, you know, go through our videos and see what pertains to you and your business and learn. And if you have questions, just give us a call or email us at sales@skinforlife.com. So everything is at your disposal. You just have to reach out and let us know what we can help you with. And we'll do our best to give you 110% of our effort so that you can progress and build your business successfully. So thank you for letting me train you with the Pure O2 Oxygen Infusion Portable System and all of its modalities. If you have any questions, you can email us, sales@skinforlife.com, or call us, 866-312-7546, or visit us online, which is skinforlife.com. It's that simple. So just stay connected, and we really appreciate you taking the time to view this video. And Remember, view this video before you open your package so you're very well established, and then give us a call for your online complimentary class so that we can make sure that you understand everything about your Pure O2 system. So thank you very much, and thank you for choosing Skin for Life as your brand of choice.